In this video, we're going to look at how to finish up your paper with a title and abstract. Now, obviously, titles go at the beginning of the paper, and abstracts usually come right after the titles in the names. And they're usually formatted so they look separate from the main part of the paper. In your own research paper, which you're typing on a computer, it's a good idea to maybe single space the abstract. Titles should have a balance between length and detail. Shorter is good, but it needs to be clear and usually contains the independent and dependent variables. You should avoid starting the title with a question word like what, why, or how. So instead of this, you should write this. Okay, next, make sure you capitalize all the keywords and any word longer than three letters. Short words like of, the, in, and, these words don't need to be capitalized. Okay, let's look at some examples. These titles all explain the independent and dependent variables. Okay, for example, time estimation, that's the dependent variable. Time estimation performance before, during, and following physical activity. That's the independent variable. These titles all explain the main findings. Red enhances human performance in contests. Sad music induces pleasant emotion. Okay, so you can see that there are different kind of styles of writing your title, either using the independent and dependent variable, or explaining like the main result. And then this style uses the word effect or role, okay? The role of facial mimicry in the recognition of affect, a note on the effect of auditory stimulation on the behavior and welfare of zoo house gorillas, okay? All right, next let's talk about abstracts. The abstract is a short summary of your research paper so that people who might want to read it can decide whether it's worth reading. So it needs to be short but clear, and you should contain these things. First, a summary of the background, the purpose, and maybe the method. Okay. Next, a summary of the most important result. And then finally, a summary of what is useful or important about it, like applications, for example. Okay, so here is the abstract for the paper on that red enhances human performance in contests. We used this paper in a previous video. Here's the abstract, and this first part explains the background of the study. This part explains the main result. Okay, we find that wearing red is consistently associated with a higher probability of winning. And then this one explains the importance, or maybe you could say the application of the result. Okay, next. This is a research paper about the effect of eating breakfast on thinking. And here's the abstract written in a little bit bigger type so you could read it more easily. And as before, the first three sentences here explain the purpose of the study and a little bit about the method. Okay. And then this part explains the results in two sentences. It's a little more detailed than the other example we looked at. And finally, this part is a kind of overall summary of the meaning of the research. So you can see that some abstracts are more detailed and some are less detailed, and the content varies a little from paper to paper. But keep the main focus in mind, that you're trying to attract people who might want to read your paper.